Hello, magandang araw po sa inyo mga ka-fungsoy. Nandito na naman po si Yuri Saito, brand ambassador ng World of Fungsoy and business partner. Sa ngayon po, wala po ako sa aking teritoryo. Nandito po ako sa Kyushu, di ba? So ngayon, ano po ang ating pag-aaralan ngayon? Araw na to, it is about the rituals of moving house. Dahil marami po ang mga taong nagtatanong sa akin kung ano ba ang mga ritual ng transferring or moving a house. Ngayon, kailangan tandaan natin na kapag tayo ay magta-transfer ng or moving house, kailangan nakangiti tayo. It should be happy. Kasi nga, lilipat ka ng bagong bahay eh. So, what we need to do is, first, we select an auspicious day and hour. Ano yung auspicious day and hour? Auspicious. It's swerteng oras at saka araw. This has now been made very easy for us kasi si Madam Lillian gumawa siya ng Feng Shui Almanac para malaman natin on choosing the right day and time, and very easy process indeed. In each month, there are usually a few days that are especially auspicious for moving houses into a new home and having found these dates. And it is also very important that the day selected does not clash with the animal sign of the main party. Sino yun? Anong ibig sabihin nun? Kailangan hindi mo conflict day. It should be your good day. Hindi yung clash sa'yo. Kunwari ako, year of the rabbit ako pinanganak. Tapos yung araw na yun is year of, not year of the rabbit, but day of the rabbit. Tapos day, month of ng kalaban ko, which is rooster. Hindi maganda. It should be month ng magandang animal sign for you. So you should select the best day and month for the animal signs of the main parties. This is really vital as a clash will render the move inauspicious. Anong ibig sabihin? Imbis na swerte ang mangyayari sa inyo, magiging malas kayo. So as such, the moving in date needs to be very carefully worked out. Kailangan meron kayong almanac. Huwag na kayong magtanong sa akin. Bumili na lang kayo ng almanac at ituturo ko na lang sa inyo kung kailan ang magandang araw o oras para sa paglipat ninyo ng bahay. So it is also more auspicious to move in during the 15 days of the waxing moon, i.e. when the moon is rising, rather than during the second half of the lunar month when the moon is waning. And it is preferable moving in during the morning. Kailangan umaga. Morning hours as opposed to the afternoon hours. This ensures that you will bring excellent sunshine, young energy into the home with you. So the main ritual, eto na, punta tayo sa main ritual. Prior to moving into the home, it is a good idea to make the incense offering to the local landlords and spirits of the land. Okay, kailangan bumili kayo ng incense. Hindi yung basta-basta incense, because we have World of Feng Shui taught us the mantra that we should chant during the incense offering to your house. So it should be done during morning hours before the family moves in prior to the moving in date. Naintindihan niyo yun? Prior to the moving in date. Kailangan, ano, bago kayo pumasok doon, you need to incense first. Namasarva tatagata avalokiti om samra samraong. Namasarva tatagata avalokiti om samra samraong. Yun ang kailangan ninyong gawin. So this is an excellent to appease them, and the ritual ensures that the spirits do not create obstacles for the family. It is simply so important that the family can live in harmony with the spirits of the land and the goddesses of the earth. So, getting the spirits of the cosmic realms on your side is a powerful method of spiritual feng shui. And it ensures that life in the new house will not just be safe and secure for the family, but also that there will be abundance and good fortune. This is an important dimension of ensuring that life in the new house will be smooth, prosperous, and happy, and there will always be longevity of good feng shui. So now, the incense offering ritual should be done early in the morning hours before the family moves in. Prior to the moving in date, furniture and clothes can already be moved in. The official moving in date is the day when the family moves in the beds and sleeps in the house thereafter. So by the day the family moves in to live in the house, quite a lot of the furniture has already been moved in. It is also a good idea to ensure that before the family moves in, that all the lights switches work. Kailangan, ano, walang, ano, yung isa, pundido, ganun. No. Kailangan, ano, lahat. Okay. Walang, ano, sira. Yung plumbing works, and most important of all, kailangan lahat yan. Okay. Walang sira. That the kitchen is in good functioning order. I-check ninyong lahat. As part of the moving in ritual involves boiling water. Kailangan mag-boil kayo ng water and cooking something sweet. Kailangan, ano, yung malagkit, yung sweet, ganon. Yun ang, ano ninyo, ihanda ninyo o gawin ninyo. Turning on the stove. On the day of the move, everything must work. Kailangan walang sira ang buong bahay. Ngayon, eto na. Stepping over the fire. Anong ibig sabihin nun? Ano, as the designated hour, burn some charcoal. Maglagay kayo ng ano, charcoal is yung uling. Okay? And as the family enters the main door into the home, ilagay ninyo doon yung charcoal na kailangan, wag naman yung doon sa lapag mismo. Kumuha kayo ng lalagyan, yung hindi pa nagagamit na lalagyan. And then, ano, step over the fire into the home, one by one. The family enters the main door into the home, they should one by one step over the fire into the home. Ngayon, ang unang papasok ay ang tatay ng tahanan, the patriarchs. Should carry a golden rice urn. Ano yung golden rice urn? Kailangan, sa amin kasi, sa World of Feng Shui, we have a rice urn that is gold. Okay, gold. Kung wala kayong makuha, ano, futsong, ano, ordinaryong rice urn na lang lalagyan ng bigas. Na talagang half filled with rice. Hindi mo pupunuin yun. Yung tatay hindi dapat pupunuin yun. Okay? Ano, half filled with rice as he walks over the fire and into the home. This signifies that he will be the principal provider of the home. Carrying the rice urn symbolizes wealth, and it being half full indicates there is room for more wealth to come. So, ibig sabihin, kalahati lang ang ilalagay mo dahil ang ano, yung kalahati, meron pang ano, malalagyan ng ano, ng wealth. It symbolizes wealth, and it being half full indicated there is more room for more wealth to come. O, diba? Walking over the fire means leaving all the bad luck behind, as the fire element has great relevance in getting rid of all misfortune luck. So, kailangan tandaan ninyo yan. And it is very important that the patriots, ang tatay, must long wear pants. Kailangan, nakasuot ka ng pantalon na mahaba, which signifies abundance last a long time. The patriots must not wear shorts, pants, or anything that looks old, faded, or torn. Hindi siya faded. This is considered extremely inauspicious. Malas po yun. So, the matriots, ang nanay, should carry a pillow as she steps over the fire again. This signifies that she can sleep well with no worries and that her life will be one of great good fortune. It is also signifies that there will be no problem arising out of infidelities and other misfortunes causing the marriage to go wrong. Hawak-hawak ng nanay ang pillow and then magpapas over sa charcoal para ma-ensure na walang infidelity o hindi mangangaliwang iyong asawa. Okay? Ngayon, the mother of the family should also wear long pants or long skirts. The mother must not wear clothes that are excessively sexy or see-through, as this is considered very unlucky for her. The best is to wear a long sarong or a long skirt. Long pants are also acceptable, but like the patriots, she should not wear anything short. Ngayon, punta tayo sa mga anak. The sons of the family should carry books as they walk over the fire, while the daughters of the family should carry flowers. This ensures the son will become brilliant scholars and have success and rise to minister's level, while the daughters will become great beauties and contract auspicious marriage. O, diba? Ang ganda para sa mga anak ninyo yan. In the old days, sons of families should bring honor to families by their rise in society, while daughters should make brilliant marriage. Ang mga babae, modern day living is not so different, as many families continue to harbor very similar aspirations. Thus, on the day they move into the home, the father should carry the golden rice urn, and then the mother should carry the soft pillow, while the kids, your children, should carry their school books. All of them wore long pants to signify longevity of abundance in their new home. If there are altars in the home, this should be consecrated and set up with water, light, food, incense, and flower offerings. Five types of offerings to ensure that everything are properly welcomed into the home at the same time. Once inside the house, the maids, if you have, who we each carry food stuff and clothes as they walk over the fire, then warm up a pre-cooked sweet, compromising sweet longan and other fruits cooked earlier with rock sugar. Then the family sits down to have a meal. Water is boiled to make a sweet tea and pot of rice is cooked. By the time you move in your house, of course, most of their furniture had already been moved in and set up. The fridge and the pantry had been filled with food, and the television is turned on to generate the young energy, and a few friends come over on hour to signify plenty of friends visiting. Conversations as they eat and laugh together should comprise only the most positive comments and remarks. Pag lumilipat po kayo ng isang bahay o mag-move house kayo, kailangan laging nakangiti. Huwag po kayong mag-aaway-away o huwag kayong magtatalo. Ang mga pamilya, hindi magtatalo-talo. Pag nandyan kayo nagsasalo-salo, it should be, ano ang dapat natin gawin? It should be always positive. Positive tayo para maging maganda ang ating pagsasama sa bago nating bahay. So ito, nagtatapos tayo dito sa ano, tungkol sa ano, paglipat ng bahay. So ngayon, ano pa ang dapat kong ituro sa inyo? Continuation of this is to purify energy in your living space using the singing bowl. Ano 'yon? May singing bowl ako sa bahay. Not only my bahay, it's also my office, and itinuturo ko rin po sa mga gustong matuto ng feng shui at kung paano natin i-clear o ipupurify ang the energy in our living space by using the singing bowl. Ano ang dapat nating gawin? Buy a very good singing bowl. Space purification clears away negative vibrations. Kung meron kayong singing bowl, lahat ng negative vibrations will be cleared, allowing fresh new energy to enter your home. A cleared space puts us in touch with the soul and energy of the universe so that we live in harmony with each other and our environment. Space purification is done using incense. Ayan na. Incense followed by the singing bowl purification. So once you do the incense offering, then do the to purify the energy. You have already cleansed your living space, then purify the energy by the singing bowl. So space purification is done using incense followed by the singing bowl purification. As your living space is cleansed with regular use of singing bowl, it's metallic sa kailangan metallic. Kay Madam Lillian kasi nandyan, may mga mantras yan. Different kinds of mantras inilagay niya for us. Okay? For us to use. It should be a metallic sound. Will get purer and sharper each day to reflect cleaner energy around you. Ito yung characteristic of a good singing bowl. Should ideally have a shining golden color. Ipapakita ko sa inyo one of these days. Should ideally have a shining golden color, be fairly thick, kailangan makapal, and perfectly round. Can be polished or matte in any metallic shade. When singing bowls are rubbed, hit or tapped, they produce a wonderful, pure and lasting sound. This is true even if you tap it with your fingernails. The quality of sound is determined by the thickness of the bowl's rim. Its humming resonance and singing vibrations depend on its depth. It is made from 7 types of metals. Ito yung 7 types of metal. To produce the special singing sound, the bowl should have a round crucible shape and be made from 7 different metals: silver, gold, tin, copper, zinc, iron, and lead. Adding real gold into the bowls improves the sound, and it symbolizes the auspiciousness of the gold. Yung swerte. The seven types of metals are tradition. Gold represents the sun, the ultimate source of yang energy. Silver represents the moon. the ultimate source of wind energy. Hence, using silver and gold represents the union of yin and yang inside the bowl itself. The other metals, it represents the planets in the universe. Each of the seven metals produces its own individual sound, and together they produce an exceptional singing sound that pierces through the energy of space. Striking the ball with mallet. Striking the ball with mallet three times creates the first set of sound. Three times. Let the sound ring out loud and follow its resonance. As the sound begins to fade, strike again and keep doing this as you move around the room. Humming the bowl with the mallet. Anong ibig sabihin yan? You can also slide. Yan. You can also slide the mallet around the rim of the bowl in a clockwise direction to generate a singing, ringing sound. Keep a firm tension on the mallet and listen as the gentle humming sounds intensity. If at first you cannot get the bowl to hum using this method by striking the bowl first, ganyan, iganyan mo siya or iganom mo siya, wake it up before sliding the mallet around the rim. The trick is in the continuous pressure or the pressure of the mallet against the rim. Gently pressing the rim evenly and firmly. When you get good at it, the sheer beauty of the sound will carry you away. These methods brings out the harmonics of the bowl. When your bowl is singing nicely, begin to walk slowly around the room with your singing bowl. Okay? Try to stay close to the wall so that any unbalanced energy that may be stuck to the walls gets cleansed and purified by the sound. Circle doors and windows are areas three times in clockwise direction. Kailangan tatlong beses. So we go on the incense purification. You may also perform incense purification before singing your bowl. Yun kanina. Anong tawag dito? Incense offering. Incense fills the home with pure, balanced yang energy, especially if the incense is made from special mountain plants and herbs. Incense appeases local spirits, and when followed by the singing bowl purifications, generates immense harmony. Okay? Now, focus your mind. Kailangan may focus your mind. The singing bowl purification also acts as the therapy method to open up the chakras of the human body. As you are cleansing your living space with the singing bowl, focus your mind towards clearing negativity energies in your body and mind, as well as around you. Ngayon, ano yung benefits of singing bowl purification? It clears away negative energies of a living space that originate from feng shui afflictions, quarrels, and events. Second, transforms inauspicious energy into auspicious energy. Number three, activates elemental energies of metal sectors of the home, which is northwest for the patriarchs and west for the children. Open up the chakras of the human body and cleanses your mind, giving you a sense of uplift and relaxation after bathing in the harmonic tones of a singing bowl. And then enhances the effectiveness of feng shui cures, leaves positive vibrations that make homes home with happiness. Now, using the bowl in space purification. Let the singing bowl sit comfortably on a special cushion in your upturned left palm. Dito. Spend a few seconds tuning into the heaviness of the bowl. Then lift the wooden mallet and gently strike the rim of the bowl. Ganon. Each person will hear a different kind of humming of singing bowl. Strike the bowl continues to get familiar with the sounds that permeate the room. Close your eyes slightly and allow yourself to be enveloped by the sounds creates the waves created. Hold the bowl in your left palm and walk slowly from room to room into your home. In each room, strike the bowl 3 times again and move in a clockwise direction around the room. Listen to the sounds generated from the bowl. Sounds produced in dead corners are often flat and dull, while those that come from a lively part of the home tend to be sharp and clear. Ano ang ibig sabihin nun? For example, nagpunta kayo sa isang room na parang negative siya. Iba po ang tunog ng inyong singing bowl. Pero pag nandun kayo sa anong tawag dito, yung maliwanag, yung lagi ninyong, lagi kayong nandoon, iba po ang tunog ng inyong singing bowl. So, yun ang sinasabi dito na listen to the sounds generated from the bowl. Sounds produced in a dead corners are often flat and dull, while those that come from a lively part of the home tend to be sharp and clear. Learn to tell the differences. This first round through the home allows the bowl to resonate everywhere. It will balance the energies in your home almost instantly. If you have a room you considered being especially unlucky, place the bowl on a table with a cushion underneath. Let the bowl steady itself and then strike the rim of the bowl with the wooden mallet. So mga ka-feng shui, dito na po nagtatapos ang ating to learn with me about the purification of the singing bowl and transferring a new home. Sa mga hindi pa po nakakapag-subscribe sa akin channel, paki-click na po ang button at lahat, kalimbangin na lahat, para lahat ng mga upcoming videos ko, manonotify po kayo. Ako po si Yuri Saito na nagsasabing, hate what is evil and hold on to what is good. Do not let evil defeat you, instead conquer evil to good. Salamat po, maraming salamat. Love from Saga.